How to deal with bailiffs and high court enforcement officers at the door. Introduction. Due to the government's coronavirus legislation and guidance, many families will be finding themselves in great financial difficulty over the next months and years. Many people across the class divide will find themselves in financial difficulty due to no fault of their own. I'm going to go through some situations when bailiffs or enforcement officers may come to your door. Local authorities, mainly contract bailiffs, who work for a private company to collect unpaid council tax and PCNs, parking tickets. High court enforcement officers work directly for the High Court and County Courts. They have a power to enter premises by force for existing unpaid High Court and County Court debts at business premises, or any premises where an enforcement officer is enforcing criminal fines. Now in this video I'm only going to talk about the legislation regarding civil debt at residential premises only. The legislation is applied differently when it comes to civil debt at business premises or if they are collecting unpaid criminal fines or unpaid HMRC taxes. The legislation I'm going to talk about is the Tribunals, Courts and Enforcement Act 2007, Schedule 12. Taking Control of Goods Regulations 2013, amended 2014. And the Ministry of Justice, Taking Control of Goods, National Standards 2014. Now if you're at the stage bailiffs are knocking at your door, the situation can be quite tense. You must understand bailiffs work on commission, they will pressure you no matter what your situation is, to settle the debt in full that includes their fees. This is how they get paid. Video the encounter on your smartphone to ensure against any procedural improprieties on the part of the bailiffs or enforcement officer. The most important thing you need to know at this point is under no circumstance, never let any bailiff or enforcement officer into your home. If you let them in or they walk through an unlocked door, they would have made peaceful entry. So, it is very important you understand that, if you're expecting bailiffs or enforcement officers to visit your home, keep your doors locked at all times and never invite them in. It's also worth to note, nowhere in the legislation does it state the occupant must let a bailiff or enforcement officer into their home. They can only make peaceful entry by normal means only. What this means is the usual way you can enter the premises. In most instances on residential property this would be via the unlocked front or back door, or garage only. They cannot climb through open windows or over walls. Please be aware the first item of property a bailiff or enforcement officer will go for is your car. They can only clamp or take your vehicle if you own it and free of finance. They cannot clamp or remove vehicles that do not belong to the debtor or are displaying a valid disabled badge. Powers. When a bailiff or enforcement officer visits your home, they will imply they have a right in law to enter your home to take your property if you refuse to pay them. This is partially true in some instances when they have previously made peaceful entry. Now what they don't tell you is that they are governed by the same legislation that they are trying to scare you with. What powers they have will depend if they are a bailiff or a high court enforcement officer. When a bailiff visits your home, he or she will be in possession of a warrant of control. A enforcement officer will be in possession of a writ of execution. Now both of these statutory instruments have limited powers when dealing with civil debt on residential premises. When it comes to the Tribunals, Courts and Enforcement Act, Schedule 12, Taking Control of Goods, a certificate bailiff or enforcement officer in possession of one of these statutory instruments has the lawful authority under the court to present themselves at your property to take control of goods, to sell against the debt if payment isn't received. In particular reference to Schedule 12, Section 14, Entry Without Warrant. Part 1, an enforcement agent may enter relevant premises to search for and take control of goods. The key words are entry without warrant and relevant premises. This is why a bailiff or enforcement officer really pushes for peaceful entry to residential premises when collecting civil debt. Peaceful entry. When a bailiff or enforcement officer has managed to make peaceful entry, their power increases. This opens up the playbook for bailiffs and enforcement officers. Once he or she is inside your property, they have pretty much got you over the barrel. They will complete a Regulation 15 signed control of goods agreement with the named debtor that allows them to take legal ownership over your property to secure against the debt. In most instances, they will arrange a repayment plan. If the debtor fails to pay or keep up with the agreed payments, then the bailiff or enforcement officer under Schedule 12, Section 15 and 16 can come back and force entry with a locksmith to execute the warrant or writ under the previous Regulation 15 contract. Dealing with bailiffs or enforcement officers that have been unable or prevented from making peaceful entry. Under the current legislation, a debtor is under no legal obligation to assist a bailiff or enforcement officer. There is also no requirement for you to identify yourself to a bailiff or enforcement officer. You cannot be arrested for not complying with a bailiff or enforcement officer's requests to enter your premises. There are many videos on the internet of bailiffs and enforcement officers misrepresenting their powers to intimidate people, to forcibly get them to comply with their requests. If you refuse or prevent a bailiff or enforcement officer from making peaceful entry and they are threatening to make an application to the court to force entry with a locksmith, they are just trying to get you scared so you will comply to their threats. Currently, there are no prescribed court procedures for a bailiff or enforcement officer to have an audience at a magistrate's court to make the application. Due to the fact magistrates' courts don't deal with civil debt and only magistrate can issue a warrant to force entry. The only time a bailiff or enforcement officer can apply for a warrant to force entry is under Schedule 12 of the Tribunals, Courts and Enforcement Act 2007. Rule 10C of the Criminal Procedure, Amendment, Rules 2015 for criminal penalties or unpaid HRMC taxes. Furthermore, the Taking Control of Goods National Standards 2014, Paragraph 60 states, a power to enter premises by force exists only for the execution of high court and county court debts. At business premises or at any premises where an enforcement agent is enforcing criminal penalties, a bailiff or enforcement officer only has 12 months to pursue the debt from the date of issuances of the notice of enforcement. If they are unable to collect, then the debt is sent back to the original issuer. The Citizens Advice website has good information on stopping bailiffs at the door.